She does not regret her tweet from earlier this month, earlier in June, where she lumped Israel, the United States, Hamas, and the Taliban together.
Do you regret these comments?
I don't. I was addressing Secretary of State Blinken. The cases are put together in front of the ICC. ICC has been investigating. I know that, you know, some of my colleagues don't lend legitimacy to the ICC.
But when they make these statements, these lumping Hamas with Israel, with the United States, with the Taliban, these are really dangerous statements on an international platform that this congresswoman is making.
I've served as a Green Beret. I've fought all over the world. I have seen women at the hands of the Taliban abused, acid thrown on their faces, girls' schools burnt down, one even machine gunned with the girls in them. So to put the Taliban on the same level with Israel, with the United States, is jaw-droppingly offensive. It's ridiculous.
About a month ago, Jay, when she made those troubling remarks, you finally got a joint statement from Speaker Pelosi and her leadership team, sort of softly condemning it. But we said this at the time, Jay, if she says those words and doesn't actually take any action, it doesn't mean a whole lot. About the same time, there was a letter sent condemning the actions by 12 Democrat members of the House. So clearly, Congressman Omar is pushing up against that line.
Even more imperative that we call out House Speaker Pelosi and the Democrat Party leadership in the House. What have they done? Virtually everything they have done has simply encouraged Ilhan Omar to go further. Why? There are no repercussions so far.
She has a deep view that is at fundamental odds with the way America protects itself, protects its own people. They should have to declare. Now, you got to pick a side on this one. You can't say, oh, we talked to her and she issued a statement. That's all just silliness. We know what she believes, and we need the leadership in the Democrat Party to distance itself from them.
Voters send members of Congress to Congress, but it is the party leaders who decide what their message on each committee is. Right now, Jordan, the Democrat Party in Washington, D.C. is saying what Congressman Omar is saying, that is the message we want to put out on the Foreign Affairs Committee. If that's not the message that Speaker Pelosi wants to put out, Jordan, there's only one action for her to take. She needs to be off the committee, and she needs to be off the committee today.
Our foreign arms sales, our foreign military sales and foreign military financing passes through that committee for approval. That's exactly where the arms packages go for Israel, our support to Israel and to so many others. And she's a voting member of that committee. And that is incredibly disturbing to me. And I hope when we win the majority back, we remove her from the committee.
She's also taken the second step, which is to say it's the reason she speaks out this way is because her colleagues who have been more have condemned her, and specifically her Jewish colleagues, don't understand this fight for injustice, haven't been involved in the fight for injustice like she has.
Do you understand why some of your fellow House Democrats, especially Jews, find that language anti-Semitic?
I think it's really important for these members to realize that they haven't been partners in injustice. They haven't been, equally engaging in seeking justice around the world. And I think, you know, I will continue to do that. It is important for me as someone who knows what it feels like to experience injustice in ways that many of my colleagues don't.
Everything she says is worse. In other words, she's just speaking what's on her mind because she actually believes this. And she's, you know, this isn't an attack on Republicans. This is attacking fellow Democrats that happen to be Jewish. And she has to call that out. So I go back to that, haven't been partners in justice. And then equating, of course, the United States with Hamas and the Taliban and Israel and should all be at the ICC. This shows a complete lack of understanding, not just history, but fact.
We all owe a deep debt to Jews the world over. Very few groups have been more consistent in fighting against injustice. She ought to consider, for instance, the fate of the Uyghurs in China, the fate of the Christians in Nigeria, Pakistan, and Iran. Where is Representative Omar? She is nowhere to be found. She is in a silo surrounded by individuals who basically have created an echo chamber and no one is prepared, apparently, to call her out.
How will Nancy Pelosi not respond to that? And those colleagues that she takes that swipe at, who, again, were the colleagues who condemned her initial statement. So they're Democrat Jewish members of Congress that she's saying don't understand injustice. To me, this, again, it puts Nancy Pelosi in that situation. Is it just going to be on a slap of the wrist, though?
There's no excuse for not responding to this if you're Speaker Pelosi. Look, Congressman Omar is telling us who she is. She may try to walk it back on Twitter, but it's happened time and time again. Actually, I thought Kevin McCarthy said it right. He said, I think Nancy Pelosi should remove Omar from the Foreign Affairs Committee. This is an individual who has not once, but on numerous occasions, been anti-Semitic.
Just understand what she did. She sought out the media to double down on these statements, to not back away, to not try to reframe, but to double down on these statements and then take another shot at a whole group of people saying they don't understand injustice. This is, again, to me, it's time for the Democrat Party to act by removing her from those committees.